guys, so lately I have a project about ActiveCampaign. She want me to create a landing page for her client. So I'm gonna show you the step-by-step process and how to do it. You don't need to be a web developer to come up with a good landing page and ActiveCampaign. So without further ado, let's begin. 1, 2, 3. All right, so when you go to the ActiveCampaign that login, so you have two options to log in to ActiveCampaign. Using the login link, so this will be, you need to specify your account name for that. So let's say, for example, Bookworm Head. So you need to specify that. Now, okay, so if you are an agency account and you have a lot of accounts associated to that ActiveCampaign, you can go to the activecampaign.com/partners/agency and then just look for the word login. So just scroll down a bit and then click accounts associated, because the first one is a sandbox, so it means it's a test plan. As you can see, there's no payment, so we're gonna use the sandbox for testing. Okay, and this is the overview page or the dashboard of ActiveCampaign. Okay, and let's try to create a page. So to do that, simply click the site, and this is the page one. So you can also create a folder if you want to. If you want to categorize all your pages, so just create a folder. But for now, let's just create a page, a test page. So in this area, you can start from scratch, or you can select some of their preset templates from ActiveCampaign. So there's a lot of templates in here. For the custom templates, you can see that one as well if you save a template. But for now, let's just use the blank template so you can really understand how the page builder looks, okay, or how it works, okay. So let's use the blank one, and I'm gonna name this test page. Okay, so in this area, you can see here that the parent one or the outer wrapper is the section, and then the inner one is the column. So the hierarchy or the level of that is the section is the first hierarchy or the first level, and row and column are the second level, and the rest are the third level, such as navigation. So I'm gonna drag a section, okay? And by the way, let's just rename that sections, and let's say I'm gonna call this one as header, and let's call the other one as body, okay? By the way, you can use this ID as well if you want to create a one pager, so that would be super helpful. Yeah, so we're done on that. Now I'm going to add a column, okay? So to add a column, you need to select the section first, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna add a column, not row, I think. It should be column, okay? Click the column. So I'm gonna add two columns for my header, the one for the image and the other one for navigation. You can also add rows if you want to, but for now, let's just remove, I think, okay. So let's just remove that row. And to remove that, click the trashed icon or press the del. Now on the two columns, I'm gonna add an image for the logo, and let's choose a logo in here, okay, and use this image. And for the second column, I'm gonna look for navigation, and let's change this color into white, okay, color. Can also add gradient, image, video, but for now, let's just keep it white, a solid white, okay? Now, let's dive into the body section. And in the body section, let's say I'm gonna add an image background. So this will be our hero banner. So use that image, okay? So you can see in here. Now, I mean, most of the hero banners are really wide and has enough spaces or enough length. So we will add an inner spacing in that section, okay? So to do that, click the section and then go to the inner spacing. I'm gonna add 25 for the top section, or 42. And let's also add on the bottom part, okay? And now I'm gonna add a component. So what would be the components that we can add? Headline maybe. Okay, headline would be perfect. I'm gonna add another paragraph. And yeah, I think this is perfect already. But it looks like you can barely see the paragraph. So we will add, let's try to add a overlay gradient, okay? What is good thing about ActiveCampaign as well is you can add an overlay gradient on top of your image background, okay? I'm gonna add another component called button, and for the buttons you can come up with different sizes or a shape. You want it to be cursive or rounded, so it depends on you. Now I'm gonna add more space in the paragraph so it has more room to breathe, okay? So that's really how it works. You just need to drag and drop all the components, okay? Also, there is a view mode. So if you want to make adjustment on the mobile, so let's say that one, you want to adjust the, let's try to adjust the, maybe the inner pages. So go to the inner pages and then I'm gonna make it 5. And this one is 0 or probably 2. It depends on you. So let's say this one for the hero banner as well. I mean, it's too long, or the padding is too high for the mobile version. You can also adjust that one without ruining, or you know, without ruining your desktop version. Okay. So that's it, guys. If you are good on this template, this page, you can save it as templates, by the way. So if you want to reuse this design in some of the pages, then you can save it as templates. So just click that one and then name the template, but we won't use that one because that is only a test page, so I would not create a template for that. But yeah, and let's save it for later. But ActiveCampaign will automatically do the changes every time you do an update to a page. So it's not really necessary to just click the save pages, or you can just simply exit that one. Okay, so that's it.